Sitaram.
Jai Sitaram.
I know it's a warm night, but a special warm welcome to each and every one of you. On behalf of the Ramdas family, my father-in-law, my mother-in-law, all the extended family, you are now part of the family. So welcome to all. We say pranams to Panaji, our learned Vyas. Welcome to this humble abode. And may this next five nights be truly rewarding for all of us, as it will be for you, imparting your knowledge unto us. We say Sitaram to Pandit Fuji, our resident Pandit, Pandit Rajendra Madhu, and to all the other Pandits who are here, Pandit from Port of Spain, to the shooters, to the musicians, and to you, our special guest, the guests. Sitaram pranams. This is just a welcome, it will not be long. To the members of the Ramlila Committee, special Sitaram, you really livened up the evening, and we say a special Sitaram to you. To all the viewers on Sankhya TV, we also say welcome. You are also part, and you belong here. You may not physically be here, but we say welcome to each and every one of you. For the next five nights, this Devi Yajna is special and very, very special, so in that the family is celebrating their 50th wedding anniversary. So this is truly, truly a grand event. Let me say that there are more seats provided. There are seats on the outside, and tonight is the starting. We will try to make you a little more comfortable. The place is extremely warm. With that, I say, Sitaram, I pass you on to Baba, who would carry you on for the next five nights. I know he will thrill all of us. Jai Sitaram.
प्रेम से बोलिए गजानंद स्वामी की जय, उमापति महादेव की जय, पवन सुत हनुमान की जय, नव दुर्गा देवी माता की जय। आप लोग कराओ जाए, प्लीज स्टैंड एज़ जॉइन ऑन दिस द फर्स्ट नाइट ऑफ आवर फाइव नाइट्स देवी यज्ञ, विजुअलाइजिंग द ब्यूटीफुल फॉर्म ऑफ भगवान श्री गणपति लॉर्ड गणेश ऑन दिस वेरी स्पेशल occasion. We pray that universal Lord and Divine Master, may you guide us in thought, words and deeds, O Ganesh Baba. As we stand together as one family, bound to each other with love and with respect, ready to serve as an army, courageous and disciplined, ever ready to fight against all low tendencies within and without us. Prabhu, with faith and with love, in preparation to listen to the Katha and the glories of Ma, please bless us. Om Gajananam Bhuta Ganadi Sevitam Kapijta Jambhu Palasaru Bhakshitam Umasutam Shoka Vinashakarakam Namami Vigneshwar Pada Pankajam Samukascha Ikadantascha Kapilo Gajakarnaka Lambodarashta Vikto Vignanasho Vinayaka Dumraketu Ganadhyaksho Baluchandra Gajanana Dwadasaitani Namani Pratatyakshanayadapi Vidyarambe Vivahishta Praveshe Nagamistatha Sangrame Sankatashchaiva Vignatasmai Najayate Shuklambaradaram Vishnu Shashivaranam Chaturbujam Prasannavaranam Dhyaye Sarva Vigno Pashantaye Vinadhare Vipula Mangal Danashile Bhaktarthi Nashini Viranchi Harisha Vande Kirti Prade Akila Manorath De Mahahe Vidya Pradayini Saraswati Naomi Nityam. Together everyone. Gurur Brahma Gurur Vishnu Gurur Devo Maheshwarah Guru Sakshat Param Brahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. ओम श्री अनुभवानंदाय नमः, ओम श्री चिन्मयानंदाय नमः, ओम तपोवनाय नमः, ओम श्री शंकराय नमः, ओम श्री व्यासाय विश्वरूपाय नमः, ओम श्री परमात्मने नमः। सुनो मोरी देवी पर्वतवासिनी, तेरा पालन पाया माँ, तेरा पालन पाया। देवी पर्वतवासी तेरा पालन पाया, तेरा पालन पाया। सुन मोरी देवी पर्वतवासी तेरा पालन सुपारी बजानारिया, पान सुपारी बजानारिया, इतने भेद चढ़ाया माँ, इतने भेद चढ़ाया। सुमोरी देवी पर्वतवासी तेरा पालन पाया, सुवा चोल तेरे अंग विराजे, केशर तिलक लगाया माँ, केशर तिलक लगाया। सुन मोरी देवी वेद परे तेरे द्वारे, ब्रह्मा वेद परे तेरे द्वारे, शंकर ध्यान लगाया, शंकर ध्यान लगाया। सुन मोरी देवी पर्वतवासी पग तेरे आगे आया, नंगे पग तेरे आगे आया, सोने का छत्र चढ़ाया माँ, सोने का छत्र चढ़ाया। सुन मोरी देवी पर्वत बांधरी वाला, ऊंचे पर्वत बांधरी वाला, नीचे शहर बसाया, नीचे शहर बसाया। सुन मोरी देवी युग त्रेता द्वापर माधे सतयुग त्रेता द्वापर माधे कलयुग राज समाया कलयुग राज समाया सुमुनि देवी पर्वत वासी दीपनैवेद्यारती मोहन भोगल गाया मा मोहन भोगल गाया सुन मोरी देवी भगत मया त्रिगुण गावे दानु भगत मया त्रिगुण गावे मन वांछित पल पाया मन वांछित पल पाया बोलो सुन मोरी देवी दुर्गे दुर्गे जय जय मां दुर्गे 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 जय जय मां
दुर्गे
करुणा सागर कालिका पालनी मां जगत धारिणी
मां
ओ जगत धारिणी
मां
सत साईं जय जय मां सत साईं जय जय मां दुर्गे 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 जय जय मां दुर्गे दुर्गे जय जय मां
दुर्गे दुर्गे
धरणी गर्भसंभूतं विद्युत्कांति समप्रभं कुमारं शक्तिहस्तं तं मंगलं प्रणमाम्यहम् ओम श्री अंगारकाय नमः ओम श्री अंगारकाय नमः ओम श्री अंगारकाय नमः ब्रह्मा मुरारी त्रिपुरांतकारी मानुषी भूमि सुतो बुधश्च पुरुष शुक्र शनि राहु केतवे सर्वे ग्रह शांति कारा भवन्तु सर्वे ग्रह शांति कारा भवन्तु सर्वे ग्रह शांति कारा भवन्तु इट्स ऑल फ्री लेट्स बी चांत शांति Let there be peace in the heavens, on the earth and in the nether region, in our homes, in our lives, in our bodies, our mind, our soul. Let there be peace wherever we are. May the food that we eat bring peace. May the herbs and the plants be peaceful. May there be peace in our nation, by extension the world. Om Shanti Antariksh Shubham Shanti Prithvi Shanti Aapah Shanti Oshadhi Shanti Vanaspati Shanti Vishwadeva Shanti Brahma Shanti Sarvagam Shanti Shanti Reva Shanti Sama Shanti Ridhi Om Shanti 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 बोले जगदम्बा देवी माता की जय उमापति महादेव की जय आसन पर बैठ जाइए प्लीज बी सीटेड प्रेम से बोलिए जगदम्बा देवी माता की जय, उमापति महादेव की जय, पवन सुत हनुमान की जय। It's a great pleasure, my friends, on behalf of Shri and Shrimati Tilakram Ramdas and family, better known as Balu, we would like to take this opportunity to say a very warm and special welcome to each and every one of you on this, the first night of five nights, Devi Yagya, glorifying and praising the Divine Mother of this universe. It's with great pleasure on behalf of this family, we thank you all for coming and of course for being part of this wonderful celebration. As we were told by the beloved son-in-law that they are celebrating their 50th wedding anniversary. And indeed, my friends, it's an auspicious occasion. 50 years wedding anniversary is indeed a moment to celebrate and a milestone to celebrate. So it's with great love and great faith this family have come together to thank the Divine Mother for her grace and for her guidance for the past 50 years. This evening, puja was conducted by your Pandit in your community, our beloved Pandit Rajendra Madhu, who is lovingly called as Fuji. We want to say thank you, Baba, and for establishing puja and of course the consecration of the devis and devatas upon the altar. Pandit Fuji is a member of this community and he is well respected and of course honored, and we want to thank him for creating this wonderful vibration through the medium of worship this evening. To the members of the Chinmaya Gyan Kirtan Mandali, we say a very warm and special welcome to all the members. Also, we have Vidya, a former member of Tableland. She is one of our chorus singers, and we're going to say thanks to her. And of course, her beloved husband Rishi, their son Avinash, and our beloved Shamji on the keyboard. Our sound engineer this evening, once again, our beloved Krishna Sounds, and of course, tonight operator will be none other than his brother Beb. A special welcome to him. My friends, we also like to say a very warm and special welcome to all the viewers on Sankit Television. And we would like to welcome all the viewers who are viewing locally as well as internationally in other parts of the world on www.sankittv.com. We would like to welcome our beloved Didi, Shirley Didi, and of course, her beloved Dharmapati, Bhaiya Ramesh, and of course, their son Omkar this evening, and the corporate sponsors who are making tonight's broadcast possible. Special thanks and blessings to the management and staff of the various companies who are making the sacrifice to keep the light of Sanatan Dharma burning in the heart and homes of thousands nationwide and worldwide. And friends, you know, it's very nice to acknowledge the wonderful sacrifice that these devotees are making on Facebook and radio and TV, etc., because it reaches far and wide. Thousands and thousands of devotees listen and tune in to these Facebook pages and radio and television, etc., and the katha and the blessing of the katha can go through the screen of Sankit TV and go through the airwaves of Akashvani and go through the Facebook page of the various various Facebook page and reach the heart and homes of thousands. And for this, we want to thank you all for the sacrifices that you make and the blessings of doing this seva in the name of the Divine Mother. Tonight, our discourse will be very, very simple, but very, very important as we highlight the glories of the Divine Mother from the various texts, the Devi Bhagavatam, the Annapurna Stotram, as well as the Devi Chalisa. We shall see a very powerful message of how the Devi manifests herself and what she grants onto her devotees, my friends, in many different ways. And also the role that Bhagwan Shiva plays in the incarnation or the manifestation of Devi Ma Jagadamba. Tonight we bow to each and every one of you, and we invite you now to sit back and relax as you close your eyes as we do our invocation, visualizing the beautiful form of the Divine Mother. And of course, today is also Tuesday, meditating upon Devi Ma and Pavan Putra Hanuman Swami.
Devi Mataya Namaha. Om Ambe Bhavani Mataya Namaha.
Amma. We chant your name with love and devotion. And the moment Ma is uttered, we know that your heart will melt for your devotees. We are your children, O Devi. And tonight with humility and love, we thank you for your protection and blessing. Please accept our humble salutations as this beautiful couple, together with their children and grandchildren, celebrate their 50th wedding anniversary. Ma, 50 years ago, with your blessing, they tied the sacred knot. And today, 50 years later, this knot remained tied in spite of the challenges that they encountered in the difficult times and the history of our country and our lives. Ma, may you bless Baloji and of course his Dharmapatni, that they continue to live together and be happy with each other through your grace and guidance. May you bless the younger ones tonight, that we can take a page from their book and learn to sacrifice the way they have sacrificed, and we can also be successful as we chant your name with love. Friends, if there is a reason to say thanks to the Divine Mother, let's do so now. Thank her for life. Thank her for protection. Thank her for her blessing. Thank her for being with us all, even in times when we feel alone. And Ma, if there are any who are going through difficulties in life, marriage problems, family problems, health problems, financial problems, please extend your blessing, O Devi.
Om Jayatvam Devi Chamunde Jai Bhuta Paharini Jaya Sarve Gate Devi Kalratri Namostute Madhu Kaitava Bhavi Dravi Vaidatri Varade Namaha Rupam Dehi Jayam Dehi Yasho Dehi Dvesho Jahi न तातो न माता न बंधुर न दाता न पुत्रो न पुत्री न वृत्यो न भरता न जाया न विद्या न वक्त्रेर्ममैव गतिस्त्वं गतिस्त्वं Tvamekam Bhavani Pratamam Shailaputri Cha Dvitiyam Brahmacharini Tritiyam Chandraganteti Ushmandeti Chaturthakam Panchamam Skandamateti Shashtam Katyayaniti Cha Saptamam Kalaratri Thi Mahagauri Thi Chashtakam Navamam Siddhidhatri Cha Navadurga Prakirtita Navadurga Prakirtita Ma Navadurga Prakirtita Om Aim Hrim Klim Chamundaye Vichy Om Aim Hrim Klim Chamundaye Vichy ॐ ऐं ह्रीं क्लीं चामुण्डायै विच्चे श्रीगुरुचरणसरोजरज निज मन मुकुर सुधारि वर्णौ रघुवर विमल जसो जोदायको पलचारि बुद्धिहीन तनु जानिके सुमिरौ पवन कुमार बल बुद्धि विद्या देहु मोहि हरहु कलि संविकार
We dedicate the Hanuman Chalisa to the beautiful children tonight sitting in front depicting Sri Ram, Sita Devi, Lakshman, Bharat, Shatrughna, Hanuman Ji, and of course all the Devis and Devatas. To you children of the Ram Leela group, may the blessing and protection of Sri Ram forever be with you. It is said, do you know, that when you act like Mother Sita, you become Mother Sita. And when you act like Sri Ram, you become Sri Ram. So it is not just that you dress up like Sri Ram and like Ma Sita or like Hanuman. You have become Hanuman and you have become Sri Ram for these few moments that you are dressed like them. And you know what? You are certainly going to receive the ultimate blessing of Sri Ram and Sita Devi. To all of you who are acting, what's your name? What's your name, babe? Who are you acting like? Bharat. And you? Jai Lakshman Bhaiya. Sri Ram, Sita Devi. And you? Yeah? You Shatruhan. Very good. Shatruhan or Shatrughna, Bhagwan bless you. And you are? Bharat. And? Hanuman. I am Hanuman. My Rama Dutu. Jai Hanuman. And you are? You are Sita Devi's sister. So you must be Urmila. So, to the children, we pray that may Bhagwan Devi Ma protect you and bless you.
जय हनुमान ज्ञान गुण सागर जय कपीस तिहु लोक उजागर
When we sing, let's all clap, let's all sing along and let the power of Hanuman Ji together with Devi Ma be with us all.
जय हनुमान ज्ञान गुण सागर जय कपीस तिहु लोक उजागर रामदूत अतुलित बल धामा अंजलि पुत्र पवन सुतनामा महावीर विक्रम बजरंगी सुमति वार सुमति के संगी कंचन वरन विराज सुबेसा कानन कुंडल कुंचित केसा हाथ पात्र और ध्वजा विराजै शंकर सुवन केसरी नंदन तेज प्रताप महाजगवंदन विद्यावान गुणी चातुर राम काज करिबे को प्रभु चरित्र सुनिबे को रसिया राम लखन सीता मन बसिया रूप धरि सियहि बितावा विगत रूप धरि लंक जरावा
भीम रूप धरि असुर संहारे असुर निकंदन राम दुलारे अष्ट सिद्धि नव निधि के दाता सुपर दीन जानकी माता राम रसायन तुम्हारे पासा सदा रहो रघुपति के नासा तुम्हारे भजन राम को पावे जन्म जन्म के दुख
सुख करे संकट कटै मिटै सब पीरा जो सुन रहे हनुमत बलबीरा जय 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 हनुमान गोसाई कृपा करहु गुरुदेव की नाही सत बार पात कर कोई जो कही बंदी महासुख होई जो यहाँ पढ़े हनुमान चालीसा तुलसीदास सदा हरिचेरा की जयनाथ हृदय महादेवा बजरंगा बली बजरंगा बली
बजरंगा बली
बजरंगा बली महावीर बली महावीर बली
बजरंगा बली
बजरंगा बली
बजरंगा बली
बजरंगा बली
बजरंगा बली
महावीर बली महावीर बली
महावीर बली
महावीर बली
महावीर बली
पावन तनय संकट हरण मंगल मूर्ति रो राम लखन सीता सहित हृदय बसहु सुर हो
बोलिए पवन सुत हनुमान की सियावर रामचंद्र की सो वी डिडंट सिंग द होल एंटायर हनुमान चालीसा वी सांग पार्ट ऑफ इट बाय मिस्टेक नेवरदीलेस It is said in a very beautiful verse, Ek gari aado me puniyar, tulasi sangat sadhi ke kathe kota parad. It's a very beautiful verse that says, one second, 1 minute in satsang brings the full benefit. And it is said, if you sing one verse of the Hanuman Chalisa, you also become blessed. Tonight, my friends, our discourse is taken from the golden pages of our scriptures, and there are several of them. Devi Bhagavatam, the Annapura Stotram, etc. And it is about to tell us something very, very important. When it comes to the Divine Mother, we always would understand that from the altar of Hinduism, Twameva Mata, Chapita Twameva, Twameva Bandhu, Chasaka Twameva, Twameva Vidya, Dravinam Twameva, Twameva sarvam mama deva devam. You see that last line? Twameva sarvam mama deva devam. Apart from Lord, Prabhu, you are my mother, you are my father, you are my friend, you are my companion. Twameva sarvam, you are my everything. That is the punchline in that prayer. It says there in that mantra, you are everything to me, O mother and father. And everything means everything. Everything that we can perceive through our senses, eyes, ears, nose, tongue, etc. Everything in this universe, the Ishavasya Upanishad, the very first verse of the Upanishad says, Ishavasya midam sarvam yatkincha jagatyam jagat. That everything in this jagat, everything in this world is Ishavasya. It is part of Ishwara. It is part of God. Everything in this world is part of Paramatma, it is part of Ishwar, it is part of Bhagwan, it is part of the Divine Shakti, the Divine Mother. And what is important is, as the journey of life continues, or the journey of life begins, or continues, or whatever it might be, we have to have one goal in mind. The goal of a human being. Whether that human being is a Hindu, whether that human being is Christian, whether that human being is Muslim, whether that human being is Indian, Chinese, Japanese, Venezuelan, or Spanish.
Venezuelan, Spanish, you see? Isn't it?
Once we call ourselves a human being, there is one goal and there is one objective, my friends, and that is for us to have self-realization or God-realization or what you call liberation, as it is called in some religion. Liberation, moksha, salvation, freedom,
whatever, eternal happiness, whatever you want to call it, we can call it, my dear brothers and sisters. It doesn't matter. Religion, creed, race, position, status, wealth, education, those things does not matter. What matters is that we are working towards that goal, our spiritual goal, and while we are working towards that goal, it must be achieved. Because we have the greatest blessing, and that gift is the gift of the human existence. So the human existence is to do one thing, to reach back to where we came from. And where did you come from? Where did you come from? Where did you come from? Didi, where did you come from? We all came from consciousness. We exist in consciousness, and we shall go back to become one with that consciousness. However, while we are in this world, we forget the consciousness because of the Maya. We forget the Shakti because of the Maya. And as a result of that, we get caught up in the illusion of the world. And as a result of that, my friends, we become lost. That's why in some religion, they say some people are lost souls. We don't want to become lost souls. And when I say we, I mean we as human beings, not we as Hindus. When I say we as human beings, we mean every human existence in this earth, on this earth. We do not want to become lost souls. Therefore, friends, we have to go back to where we came from. And how to do that? That is the million-dollar question. How do we do that? Is it by doing puja? Is it by going to the temple? Is it by going to the church? Is it by changing the religion? Is it by going to the mosque? Is it to going that to have the desire to go to Mecca and get the blessing of the Lord there? Is it to go on a pilgrimage? What do we do to get back that existence, or to go back to that state of pure consciousness that where we have come from? That's very important. And friends, in order to go back to that state, notice I'm saying a state, it's not a place. To go back to that state of consciousness, what we have to do is get the mind to connect to Ishavasamidam Sarvam. Get the mind to connect to God in every aspect of this creation. Get the mind to connect to that divine Shakti in every form in this creation. Tomeva Mata, see your mother. Tomeva Mata Chapita Tomeva, see your father. Tomeva Bandhu, see your friend. Sakha Tomeva, your companion. Tomeva Vidya, you are my knowledge. Dravinam Tomeva, you are everything to me. Tomeva Sarvam Mama Deva Deva, O Divine Mother and Father, you are everything. And therefore, everything that we can see, hear, smell, taste, and touch is divine. So then where is the distraction? The distraction is when I am unable to see the goodness or the divinity that is existing in whatever object I perceive, by whatever form, when I'm unable to see that and experience that, the result of that is I am lost. Friends, some people here tonight have on their glasses. Some people don't have on their glasses. Isn't it? The people that don't have the glasses can see well. I hope. Or they just decide to leave it home. And the people who have the glasses, they also can see well with the glasses. Isn't it? So what you can see without your glasses, I will not be able to see. So I can't see my phone in front of me and what is written there without my glasses. All I am seeing is some letters jumbled up. And then you that doesn't have the glasses will tell me, but Baba, you have your eyes. And what is written there is people name and people messages. They are messaging. So what is written there, you will be able to see the message. But I am unable to see it. And I will tell you, you know what I am seeing? I am seeing lines. There are only lines. And you will say, no, Baba, they are messages. Lines of messages. I will say, no. There are no lines. There are no messages. It's only lines. Friends, you are right. The fact is, there are messages because you are seeing properly. and I am not seeing properly, and therefore I will deny. I will tell you that you are not telling the truth, all because I cannot see properly. Friends, but when I take the spectacles of proper vision and I place it over my eyes, then I will be able to tell you, oh my Lord, you are so right. There are sentences and there are messages that are given, but only with the right vision. Only with the right vision. In the same way, friends, when we have the right vision of the divinity, we will be able to see and experience that divinity or divine mother in the world around us and everything. But if we don't have the right vision, we will deny everything. Does it make sense or not? Make sense? Yes? Once we don't have the right vision, we will deny everything. You know, the common example is given in the Upanishad, where, I'll dramatize it a little bit. One man is walking in the dark, and he is walking, going from one place to another, or close to his home, and the place is dark, no street lights. And suddenly he starts to scream, and while screaming, he ran to the side of the road, and he takes up a piece of stick. And you know what he did? He ran back because he saw something and he started to beat it on the road, and it was to him a snake. And he beating the snake, what you all think it is? Huh? He started beating the snake, and then all the neighbors heard the commotion, and when they ran outside with their flashlight, they flashed the light on the snake that the man is beating. And they say, but bhaiya, what happened? He said, look, I have a snake. They say, no, it's not a snake. It is a rope. When the man is in the dark, he is frightened. When the man is in the dark, he is excited. When the man is in the dark, he is running. When the man is in the dark, he is screaming. When the man is in the dark, he is ready to faint away. But when the light of knowledge shines on the so-called snake, it turns out to be a rope. And the moment he realizes it's a rope, is he still frightened or not? Yes or no, boys? Is he frightened, you sure? Not frightened? The moment the light shines and he says, oh, this is not a snake, it's a rope, all fright and fear goes. In the same way, friends, when knowledge shines on us, and when knowledge dawns on us, when the flashlight of divine, knowledge shines in our lives, we'll realize that there is nothing to be frightened about. There is nothing to be scared about. But Baba, living in Trinidad, and you're saying don't be scared? When you read the news every day, Baba, you have to be scared what's happening. My friends, we see it happening every day, but you know what? I don't know how to tell you to do this, what I'm going to say, but we have to remove that fear. Take your precautions. Take whatever measures you have to take to protect your home, your property, your properties, your family, etc. Take whatever measure, but remove the fear and put the Lord or the Divine Mother in front. Let the Lord and Divine Mother in front. And friends, I don't know, for some reason I think that when we are frightened and we keep on thinking about it in a frightful way, we attract it. Based on that, I'm telling you, drop it from the mind. Drop the fear, drop the anxiety, go anywhere positively, and always chant the Lord's name. And when we think positive and we chant the name of the Lord, we can protect ourselves. I believe this 100%. Even though we're living in Trinidad. Hanumanji went in Lanka. What Lanka had? What Lanka had? Only demons. Lanka was full of demons. It had one godman there. That was who? Vibhishan Maharaj. One godman in Lanka, you know, and Hanumanji went in brave, and the moment he touched down in Lanka, he said, Jai Sri Ram. I'm ready for you. you know, in local language. And when he saw the little hut of Vibhishan, he saw the name of Sri Ram on it, and he felt inspired. He said, wherever the name of the Lord is written, there must be someone holy living there. And he went there to meet Vibhishan, and we all know the katha very well. When he introduced himself to Vibhishan, he told Vibhishan why he came. And Vibhishan said, yes, Mother Sita is in Lanka. And then Hanuman asked him, he said, you sure? He said, yes. Vibhishan, where is she? He said, in Ashok Vatika. Do you love her? He said, yes, I love her very much. She is my mother. I love her very much. Vibhishan, when last you went and see she? He said, I never went. Real lover? And then Hanumanji told him, he said, are you a pretender or are you for real? If you are a true devotee of the Lord, Vibhishan, and Mother Sita is suffering at the hands of your own brother, why didn't you go? And Hanumanji, friends, instilled in the mind of Vibhishan, who was the brother of Ravan, fearlessness. And when Hanumanji blessed Vibhishan, he said, I bless you, think of the Lord and do what you have to do. Friends, Vibhishan was living in a small 10 by 10 little kutia covered with karat leaves, and he was living inside there frightened of Ravan. Where there is fear, we will be denied the opportunity to receive darshan of the Divine Mother who might be in our close proximity. Where there is fear, we will not be blessed with not only darshan, but my friends, the blessing of the divinity and shakti that is all over. Fear will overtake us. We have to remove fear from our minds for every reason. Hanumanji blessed Vibhishan and he said, let us work together. Tell me where Ma Sita is. And when Vibhishan told, Hanumanji went in and Jai Shri Ram, fearlessly. Even though we are living in frightening times, even though, my friends, we are living in challenging times, even though we don't know the intention of people, yet we have to protect ourselves, but we do so with the power of spirituality. Friends, I want you all to pray more than ever. Any religion you belong to, if you're a Christian, pray. If you're a Muslim, pray. If you're a Hindu, pray. Do not give up your faith and do not give up your prayer, because that is what is going to protect us in these challenging times. That is what is going to protect us in these challenging times, my friends. Hanumanji went to Mother Sita, he found her, etc. And to make a long katha short, he said, Ma, I want you to know, I can take you up right now and carry you to Sri Ram. But that is not the instructions given. My Lord Sri Ram wants to come himself and teach Ravana a lesson. All fearlessness. Tvameva sarvam mama deva deva. That Lord and Divine Mother is everywhere in everything in this world. And so, friends, you know, after the yagya, we are going to get food. Asking, I know. Isn't it? Now, 50 years ago, Didi, Bhaiya, you all got married in a Hindu wedding? All 3 days? What is the first day called? Huh? Friday night. Oh. What is a Hindustani word or name for the Friday night of a wedding? Mati ko night is to puja Gauri Ma. So Mati ko night. So second night is called Lava, and third night is Shadi, wedding. The first night of the wedding is when the mother of the Dulahin or Dulaha goes for the Matikor and she worships Gauri Mata, worships Dharti Mata, and she places the sendur and tilak and hardi, etc., and do arati for Gauri Ma, and then take back some of the Matikor, the dirt, and she brings it back to the altar, telling Gauri Ma, today my daughter, my son, they are about to enter, they are preparing themselves to enter the second stage in life. And Ma, I am worshipping you where my daughter is going and where my son is going to live. I will not always be with them, but Ma, you will be with them in the form of protection, in the form of fearlessness. And that Matikor is placed under the Kalsa. Gauri Mata, Devi Yagya is done on the first day of the wedding. every day we partake of food. The food we eat is the goddess manifesting in our lives in the form of Annapurna Devi. Friends, a beautiful verse says,
तुम संसार शक्ति लय कीन्हा पालन हेतु अन्न दन दीन्हा अन्नपूर्ण होई जग पाला तुम ही आदि सुंदरी बाला प्रलय काल सब नाशनहारी तुम गौरी शिव शंकर प्यारी शिव योगी तुम हे गुण गावे ब्रह्मा विष्णु तुम्हें नित ध्यावे नमो नमो दुर्गे सुख करनी नमो नमो अम्बे दुख हरनी नमो नमो दुर्गे सुख करनी नमो अम्बे दुख हरनी नमो नमो अम्बे दुख हरनी नमो नमो अम्बे दुख हरनी.
So it is said here, tum sansar ma, in this sansar, in this world, shakti layakinha. Shakti layakinha meaning that you are the creative energy in this world. Palana hetu annadana dinha, and O Divine Mother, you also provide food. Palana hetu annadana dinha, you provide food to your devotees. Nay, you do not only provide food, ma, you are the food that is being provided. O Devi, thus you are worshipped as Annapurna Hoi Jaga Pala. There is a beautiful verse in the Shiv Puran that tells, listen to this beautiful verse, friends. Think of Lord Shiva and Mother Parvati.
Nityananda Kari Varabhaya Kari Saundarya Ratnakari Nirduta Kila Gora Papanakari Pratyaksha Maheshwari Praleya Chalavamsha Pavanakari Kashi Puradishwari Dikshan Dehi Kripa Valambana Kari Matarna Purneshwari Nana Ratna Vichitra Bhushana Kari Hemambara Dambari Muktahara Vilambamana Vilasa Vakshoja Kumbantari Kashmira Garuvasitaru Chikari Kashi Puradishwari Diksham Dehi Kripavalambanakari Matanapurneshwari Yoganananda Kari Ripukshaya Kari Dharmaikya Nishtakari Chandra Kanala Bhasamanala Hari Trailokya Rakshakari Sarveshwarya Kari Tapapvara Kari Kashi Puradishwari Diksham Dehi Kripavalambana Kari Mata Annapurneshwari Diksham Dehi Kripavalambana Kari Mata Annapurneshwari.
A very beautiful stotram glorifying Annapurna Devi. And friends, how it came along? This verse is saying, Tuma sansara shakti layakinha palana hetu annadana dinha, that you give food and you give wealth to those devotees who come to you. And ma, hence annapurna hui jagapala tumahi adi sundari bala, you are indeed the first queen that incarnated, O divine mother. Now, how did she get the name Annapurna? Annapurna Devi, the goddess of food. I will tell. One day, Parvati Devi, she was sitting, you know, the home of Lord Shiva is where? Kailash. Kailash Parvat. And while Lord Shiva was sitting there, Mother Parvati is sitting with him, next to him, and they are sitting under a tree. And Lord Bhagwan Shiva is in meditation 90% of the time. So he in meditation, relaxing, mind far away, absorbed in pure consciousness. Mother Parvati is just sitting and she is looking around. Look at the creation. And one day she saw Ma Lakshmi Devi. She saw all the other Devis living in beautiful kingdoms and beautiful palaces, etc. And she was waiting for Lord Shiva to open his eyes. And when Lord Shiva opened the eyes, she said, Prabhu, pranam. He said, pranam, Devi. Aap kaise hain? Bariya hain. I'm fine, Bhagwan Shiva said. Aur aap kaise hain? How are you, Devi? She said, I am fine. Can I ask you something, Prabhu? He said, yes. When am I going to live in a palace? You know, all my life I have been living under a tree, sitting with you here. I love you very much and therefore I am here with you. I want to live in a palace like all the other Devis. Can that happen? Bhagwan Shiva said no. Imagine, Didi, your Dulaha telling you can't live in a house. What you'll do? Jai Bhagwan for here. Sati Devi, Parvati Devi said, but I want to live in a palace. Lord Shiva said, Devi, we are not destined to live in a palace. Where we are living now, this is our destiny. She said, you could say whatever you want, but I am going to change my destiny. I want a house. I want a palace. So she stood up and she was very firm. And Bhagwan Shiva said, well, if that is what you want, tathastu. So shall it be. You will be blessed with a palace. And he waved a hand. By the miracle of the Ashirvad of Bhagwan Shiva, a beautiful palace came. And when the palace appeared, she said, very good, I will go and live in my palace. But I don't just want to go in the palace, I want the palace to be blessed. So we have to get the Baba to come and bless the palace. So in that time, who was the best Baba? Who was the best Baba? You all know. Best Baba that time was Ravan. Are baap, are baap. So Lord Shiva now decided to call Ravana to bless the home. And you know, Ravan came and he was a big Brahmana. Came and chanted all the mantras, all the divine stotram, and he blessed the home of Lord Shiva and Parvati Devi. And when Lord Shiva was happy, Mother Parvati was happy, time to stay in their home now, Lord Shiva said, Babaji, you know, I must give you Dakshina. In order for the home to also be blessed, I would like to give you Dakshina. What do you want? Ravan said, Prabhu, Mahadev, if you are very pleased and happy with me and you want to give me Dakshina, I want this house. I never make a mistake and ask a Baba how much, you know. A joking, right? That's why we don't have price. You know, supposed to tell a price to do anything spiritual. Spirituality have no price. It's always seva bhav. It's always divine service. So Ravana was asked, what do you want? And he said, I want the house. And Bhagwan Shiva said, tathastu, take the house. Parvati Devi and Lord Shiva ended up under the tree again. Now, it wouldn't end there. Lord Shiva, decided that he will not only leave Parvati Devi under the tree, but he is now going to create not a house or a palace, he is going to create a city for her. And friends, he lifted his Trishul and Jai Shri Ram. He meditated upon Maryada Purushottam Shri Ramchandra Ji. And my friends, at that point in time, he took the Trishul and he slammed it to the ground. And there, the earth vibrated, the lightning flashed, the rivers overflowed its bank. The place was vibrating with divine Shakti and energy.
Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
All the devotees in the heavenly region, they became scared. Something is happening. Bhagwan Shiva is reacting. My friends, the Damaru started to vibrate.
Dum, 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 dum.
Lo and behold, my friends, all the devotees who were scared at that moment, feeling the vibration of the earth, seeing the Trishul as if fire is coming out from it, at that point in time started to praise Bhagwan Shiva in order to pacify him. Maybe he is upset or angry for something. And at that time,
dum 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 damaru baje, dum 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 damaru baje, bole nath shiva damaru baje, ole bole nath shiva damaru baje, ole dum 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 damaru baje, bole nath shiva damaru baje, ole bole nath
shiva damaru baje,
shiva 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 damaru baje, bole damaru baje, bole nath shiva damaru baje, bole bole nath shiva damaru baje, bole dam 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 damaru baje,
dam 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 dam
damaru baje, bole nath shiva damaru baje, bole bole nath shiva damaru baje.
To vibrate, the sound of the damaru is Shabdanar, the sound of Om, the sound of creation. My friends, a city was created at that point in time. There, when the Trishul was struck on the ground, the Trishul created a city. And at that city, my friends, there Mother Parvati would live forever, and Bhagwan Shiva will take his abode forever. What is that city called? Meantime, the damaru, the sound of creation, and Tum Sansara Shakti Laya Kinha, the creative energy of the Divine Mother coming together, Shiv and Shakti come together in order to create this city.
Om Shiva 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 Damaru Baje,
everyone together.
Shiva 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 Damaru Baje, bole 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 nath shiva damaru baje, bole bole nath shiva damaru baje, bole dam 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 damaru baje,
dam 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 dam
damaru
baje,
bole bole nath shiva damaru baje, bole nath shiva damaru baje, bole bole nath shiva damaru
baje,
dam 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 damaru baje, dam 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 damaru baje, bole nath shiva damaru baje, bole bole nath shiva damaru baje, dam 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 damaru baje, dam 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 damaru baje, bole nath shiva damaru baje, bole bole nath shiva damaru baje, shiva damaru baje.
That beautiful city, my friends, that was created, it was called as
it is one of the sweetest, it is one of the most beautiful, and one of the oldest city in the world. The name comes in this stotram.
Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushita vama bhagam Narayana priyamananga padapaharam Varanasi urapatim Bajaveshwanatham Varanasi Purapatim Bajaveshwanatham.
That city is called as Varanasi, also called as Banaras. Friends, it is said, on earth, that is the city where Lord Shiva is permanently residing. That is the city he created for Parvati Devi. And he said, Devi, this is the city for you. Ma Parvati sat down and she is looking down at this Banaras now and seeing all the people, etc. And while they were there, people suffering for food, people suffering from poverty, people were suffering from all different type of calamity. And that time, Lord Shiva told her, he said, Devi, you must go and you provide for those in this beautiful Varanasi. Provide food for them. Take the form of Annapurna Devi Ma. And you go and give food to your children. Friends, at that time, the Divine Mother took the form of Annapurna Devi. And she went down. And you know, friends, you know, like when you have a little bit of food and you could feed everybody with it. Have you ever had that experience? You know, when you cook food for puja, yagya, etc., you always offer some to the fire, and they say the food become, it casts barakat. Every time you offer the food in the fire, the food gets barakat. Every time you offer your food to God, it becomes blessed with barakat. It will never finish. That's our belief. That's our custom. That's our tradition, and that's our faith. So Annapurna Devi took this form. She went down in Banaras and she started to feed the people. There were long lines where devotees will come, where they saw the mother in the form of Annapurna, and she started feeding them, and the food will never finish, and everyone was satisfied, but the line remained long. Lord Shiva remained in Kailash and he started to feel hungry. So he went down now to Banaras and he decided, you know what, I am her husband. Let me break the line. I could go directly to her and ask her food. And he broke the line and he went straight to her. And he said, Devi, she said, oh, you have come, Pati Dev, my beloved husband, you have come. He said, haan, my bahut bhook lag gayi, I am very hungry. Viksham dehina, give me some food. She said, hold on, join the line. And that is when this stotram came about. It said here,
Kailasa, Kailasa Chalakandaralaya Kari, Gauri Humashankari, Kaumari Nigamartha Gochara Kari, Yomkara Bijakshari, Moksha Dwaraka Vata Patana Kari, Kashi Puradishwari, Viksham dehi ma, Viksham dehi na, Kripavalambana kari, Mata Annapurneshwari.
O mother of food, O goddess of food, Viksham dehi kripavalambana kari, Mata Annapurneshwari. You are Annapurna Devi. That's why the kitchen is called as Annakshetra. The kitchen of the home is called as Annakshetra, the place where food is generated, and the place where the Divine Mother is worshipped in the form of Annapurna Devi. You always worship in the kitchen before you cook? Ladies, mothers, sisters, daughters, wives, husbands who cook, do you worship in the kitchen before you cook? Yes or no? Baba, when I go in the kitchen,
I just take the pot and slam it on the stove, and them just think I just live here. What do you feel like cooking? Every day I have to cook. Slam the pot. It's a blessing to cook food. It's a blessing for those who can prepare food. It's a blessing to those who can eat from what you have prepared. And you get the blessing of all that. And it is said when you are cooking food, every thought, vibration you have in your mind goes into food that you're cooking. So always when you cook, cook with love. Don't cook and complain. The complaint will go in the food. And everybody who eat the food will complain. Because there is vibration. There is vibration. It's not funny, you know. It's real serious business. Every time you're cooking, I'll tell you a personal thing one day. I felt real bad afterwards. I felt real ashamed of myself afterwards. One day, I was busy to go somewhere. It had to be puja, yagya, something. And I told my dulahin, I said, can you make me a cup of tea really quickly? I need to go. So I went upstairs, got dressed, came downstairs expecting tea. But she stood up by the counter and facing the opposite direction, and I hear the cup being stirred. So the tea is being made. So I sat down. I felt like I sat down for about 5 minutes, but it was about 1 minute. Because I'm busy, so you know, thinking that I have to go. So I lifted my voice and said, that tea I'm going to make today. So I get no response. I hear cups still going on. Stirring. I said, okay, I'll go on. So as I opened the door to leave, she said, here is the tea. I said, that tea will take long to make. So I walked back in the kitchen and I took the cup. And I sat down. I said, how it takes so long? And you know the voice now. The tone of the voice, because I was the man in the house. And she's the woman in the house, so I could talk how I want. So, how it took so long to make the tea? And you know I'm busy. And she said something. And I felt so ashamed of myself. That I will never forget for the rest of my life. And I tell you also, you know what she said? She said that while I was making the tea, I was chanting the Gayatri Mantra for you. I bent my head and was so ashamed of me for reacting that way. Because I am the one who go out there and tell people chant and pray and sing and when my own Dulahin is doing it, chanting the Gayatri Mantra, and when I asked her the tea the first time, she didn't even hear me because she was so caught up in it. And Om Bhurbhuvasva Om Tat Savitur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Na Prachodayat. She putting the Gayatri Mantra vibration in that tea. And here was me reacting in a negative way. Friends, very important point. When you prepare food, Annapurna Devi isn't that food. Nay, she is the food. And when we chant our mantras and when we pray and we prepare that food with love and what you call devotion, the person you become blessed, the person who eat from that food become blessed, and so that positive energy and blessing goes through the food. Because, listen to this stotram. Bhiksham dehi kripa valambana kari Mata Annapurneshwari. Ma, you are Annapurna Devi. You are in the food. You are the food. That's why also, bhaiya, when we chant Bhojan Mantra, Bhagwan Baba gave us Bhojan Mantra. Om Brahmarpanam. Listen to this mantra that comes in the Bhagavad Gita. It says, Om Brahmarpanam Brahmavihi Brahmagno Brahmanahutam Brahmevatena Gantavyam Brahmakarma Samadina Aham Vaishwanaro Bhutva Praninam Dehamashitaha Pranapana Samayuktaha Pachamyanam Chaturvidam Om Pranaya Apanaya Vyanaya Udanaya Samanaya Namaha Om Brahmane Namaha Swaha. That Bhojan mantra says, it relates to the Havan. It relates to the Agni, Hotra. It relates to the ghee is Brahman, the spoon is Brahman, the fire is Brahman, the sticks is Brahman, the sticks are Brahman, the person offering the fire is Brahman, the samagri is Brahman, everything is Brahman, everything is God. So God offering in God, for God, for the sake of God, O God. Brahmarpanam Brahmavi Brahmagno Brahmanautam. And then in the 15th chapter, Aham Vaishwanaro Bhutva Praninam Dehamashitaha Pranapana Samayuktaha Pachamyanam Chaturvidam. I am the digestive fire within the stomach of every human being, Bhagwan Krishna says in chapter 15 of the Bhagavad Gita. I am the digestive fire in the stomach to digest the food that has been partaken through the blessing of Annapurna Devi, or the Devi of food. Friends, that's why we must never take food for granted, children. Never waste food. Never take more than what you cannot eat, and never waste it. Because there are thousands of people across the world who is suffering today because they could not get a meal right in Venezuela. Right in Venezuela. Thousand, as a matter of fact, millions of people went through the day and did not get food and knows not where the next meal is coming from. Right there. Far more for Ethiopia, and far more for Africa, and far more for India, and all these places where so much of poverty can think, my friends, can be affected by. And so Annapurna Devi, that's why Hindus and Hinduism, we worship every aspect of creation. Even the food we eat, before we eat the food, we offer it to the Lord. Ma, thank you Prabhu for your blessing, because had I not had your blessing, this food would have not come. Friends, Mata Annapurna Devi left Kailash and she came down to Varanasi, and she became Annapurna Devi, and Bhagwan Shiva became the Lord of Kashi Vishwanath, of Kashi Radha, or Banaras, or Varanasi as it is called. He became the Lord. And here in this particular verse it is said, Moksha Dwara Kavata Patanakari Kashi Puradishwari. The Lord who is the master of Kashi, he will bless anyone who dies there with moksha. It is the doorway to liberation. It is the door to open to Vaikuntha. It is the doorway to Kailash. It's the doorway to moksha. Moksha Dwara. Varanasi. Anytime any one of you go to India, ask your tour guide to take you to Varanasi. Now, the current Prime Minister of India, the Honorable Modi ji, he is the MP for Varanasi, the Member of Parliament for Varanasi, and he has done tremendous work on all the different ghats where the Ganga Devi is flowing. Next stotram, the Kashi Vishwanath stotram says, Ganga taranga ramaniya jata kalapam Gauri nirantara vibhushita vama bhagam. So Ganga Devi is flowing through this very sacred city, my friends. And there also it is said, anyone who dies there, Lord Shiva and Mother Parvati, they are waiting to take the soul of that person to their heavenly abode. So that's why many people in India, when they retire, imagine this, huh? When they retire, they go to Varanasi to wait to die. Because it is guaranteed, when you die there, you get moksha. They go and wait. The Divine Mother, friends, Devi Yagya, is worshipping, meditating, contemplating upon all the different aspects of that Divine Mother. And so, in the wedding, the first part of the wedding is worship the Gauri Mata. Matikor. That's when the tasa drums and the ladies go and they worship the Dharati Mata, they dance and they have fun and they celebrate and they bring back that Gauri to place under the kalsa. And Baba will consecrate the kalsa on top of that Matikor, on top of that Gauri Devi. So, my point tonight is very, very important. Tvameva sarvam mama deva deva. Ma, you are everywhere and you are everything to me. Friends, we who are seeking and striving on the spiritual path, we have to develop ourselves in such a way that we can experience that type of shakti and divinity in and through all aspects of creation, starting from simple little things, even the food we eat. You know what the Ramayana says? Ramayana says, oh Sri Ram, those people, before they wear their new clothes, who offer it to you, Lord, go and live in the forest of their heart. A simple thing like offering clothes. You know, like when you do puja, what do? And you offer clothes? You see, when you buy a new shirt or a new shoes or a new kurta, we don't remember to offer it to the Lord. But at least when we do puja, we have the vastra dan and we say, Prabhu, thank you for the covering of not only my body and the clothes I wear, thank you for covering my character, and thank you for covering, Prabhu, my body and mind with your love and your bhakti. Vastra dan. My friends, from the altar of Sanatan Dharma, we find every reason to remember and worship and do devotion to the Lord and Divine Mother. And tonight I want to ask everyone to have that faith and bhakti and devotion that everything that you do, the Lord and Divine Mother is everywhere looking over us. Guaranteed. I promise you.
Ya Devi Sarva Bhuteshu Daya Rupena Sanstita.
Together.
Namastasyai Namo Namaha. Durga Durgati Durka Mangala Kar Sabka Man Mandir Me Ujwal Karo Kirpa Kar Riya Aisa Pyara Bahadi Maya Aisa Pyara Bahadi Maya Charno Se Lag Jau Maya Aisa Pyara Bahadi Maya जग में आकर जग को मैया अब तक ना पहचान सका अब तक ना पहचान सका क्यों आया हूँ कहाँ है जाना ये भी ना मैं जान सका तू ही अगम गोचर मैया तू ही अगम गोचर मैया कहूँ कैसे रख पाऊँ मैं ऐसा प्यार महादे मैया चरणों से लग जाऊँ मैं ऐसा प्यार महादे मैया तेरा मैं चाहूं मैं ऐसा प्यार आगे मैं कर कृपा जगदम्ब भवानी मैं बालक नादान हूँ मैं बालक नादान हूँ नहीं आराधन जप तप जानू मैं अवगुण की कान हूँ मैं अवगुण कान हूँ दे ऐसा वरदान है मैया दे ऐसा वरदान है मैया सुमिरन तेरा दिन तेरी कोत है निश दिन तेरी कोत है तेरी कृपा ही मैं या तेरी भीतर जो भी कोत है भीतर जो भी कोत है शरण लगा को मैया शरण लगा लो तुझको मैया तुझ पर बल बन जाऊं मैं ऐसा प्यार दे चरणों से लग जाऊं सब अंधकार मिटाऊं मैं ऐसा प्यार दिखा दे
देवी माँ और शक्ति माँ She is everything, my friends. And from the philosophical standpoint of Hinduism, our mission and goal is to recognize her, to feel her presence in everything in this world. My dear brothers and sisters, in this way, the mind tends to become channeled in that direction, and the soul becomes saved from the cycle of Avagaman Chakra and from the negativities of the world and society. Friends, Now is the time that we pray more than ever. In this dark age of Kali Yuga, it's only the beginning of the dark age. Hence, we have to renew our trust and renew our faith. Ma, may you be in our lives. May you come into our hearts. May you come into our homes. May you bless this anniversary, the 50th wedding anniversary, Ma. Had it not been for your blessing, we could not have been celebrating 50 years married life tonight. Oh, Ma. How can we not thank you? How can we not glorify you and praise you, Divine Mother, for your blessing thus far?
Aisa pyar bahade maya, charnon se lag jaun main. Aisa pyar bahade maya.
Prem se boliye Jagadamba Devi Mata ki jai. My friends, in this way, it is said here that she will come to us in any form. Annapurna Devi is one of the form of the Divine Mother. Annapurna Hui Jagapala, and she saves us from hunger. Tonight, I dedicate this verse and this prayer to all those who are hungry today, to all those who have not had food, and to all those who do not know where the next meal is coming from. Ma, bless them tonight. And one other prayer. We pray that Ma, in the form of Ganga Devi, may you bless the two fishermen that are missing. Bless their soul, Ma, if they have passed on. And please release their body to their mothers and to the villagers. O Ganga Devi, please listen to our humble plea tonight in prayer. O Ma, we know that you would listen and yet you respond to our prayer and our devotion. Bless the mothers who have lost their sons and the wives that have lost their husband in that tragedy. O Devi Ma, we know that you are the creative energy and also the destructive one. Ma, tonight we plead with you. Please respond to our call and to our prayer. Prem se boliye Ganga Maiya ki jai, Annapurna Devi Mata ki jai, Jagadamba Devi Mata ki jai. Friends, with this message tonight, I would like to conclude in this katha, and we pray that may we understand that simple prayer that we say, Tomeva Sarvam Mama Deva Deva, and Isha Vasamidam Sarvam Yatkincha Jagatyam Jagat, how this prayer has philosophical meaning that can create lots of wisdom in our lives. And may we all be blessed, may we all be blessed to feel and experience that Shakti and Divinity wherever we are. Let's all please stand. As Baba has just completed the Purnahuti, and we invite everyone to lift your hands and receive the blessing of the Havan as we pass three times over our head. Om Shri Annapurna Devi Mataya Namaha, Jagadamba Devi Mataya Namaha, Om Shri Sarveshwaraya Namaha. We join in final arti. We sing the Divine Aarti to glorify and praise the Divine Mother Jagadamba Gauri.
Jai Ambe Gauri Maiya, Jai Shama Gauri. Jai Ambe Gauri Maiya, Jai Shama Gauri. निश दिन ध्यावत हरि ब्रह्मा शिव जी, ब्रह्मा शिव जी। जय अम्बे गौरी मैया, जय श्यामा गौरी। सिंदूर विराजत ती को मृग मद को उज्ज्वल से दो नैना, उज्ज्वल से दो नैना चंद्र वदन नी को। जय अम्बे गौरी मैया, जय श्यामा गौरी। राजे पुष्प दलमाला कंतहार साजी जय अम्बे गौरी नैया जय क्षमा गौरी
रामचंद्र की जय उमापति महादेव की जय पवन सुत हनुमान की जय नव दुर्गा देवी माता की जय अन्नपूर्ण देवी माता की जय प्रेम से बोलिए सत्य सनातन धर्म की जय जय सीताराम।
Sangya Television is not only the first Hindi TV station in Trinidad and Tobago, but Sangya TV also has the most coverage. You can find Sangya Television on YouTube by searching for Sangya Television.